I was on the outskirts of a little southern town, trying to reach my destination before the sun went down. The old CB was blaring away on channel 19 when there came a little boy's voice on the radio line. And he said, "Breaker 19, is anyone there? Come on back, truckers, and talk to Teddy Bear." Well, I keyed up the mic and said, "You got it, Teddy Bear." And the little boy's voice came back on the air. "Appreciate the break. Who we got on that end?" I told him my handle, and then he began. "Now, I'm not supposed to bother you fellas out there. Mom says you're busy and for me to stay off the air. But you see, I get lonely and it helps to talk, 'cause that's about all I can do. You see, I'm crippled and I can't walk." I came back and told him to fire up that mic, and I'd talk to him just as long as he'd like. "This was my dad's radio," the little boy said, "but I guess it's mine and Mom's now, 'cause my daddy's dead. Dad had a wreck about a month ago, and he was trying to get home in the blinding snow. Mom has to work now to make ends meet, and I'm not much help with my two crippled feet. She says not to worry, that we'll make it all right, but I hear her crying sometimes late at night. You know, there's one thing I want more than anything else to see. Oh, I know you guys are too busy to bother with me, but you see, my dad used to take me for rides when he was at home. But I guess that's all over now, since my daddy's gone." Not one breaker came on the old CB as that little crippled boy talked with me. I tried hard to swallow the lump that was in my throat to stay down, as I thought about my boy back in Greenville town. Dad was gonna take Mom and me with him later on this year. Well, I remember him saying, "Someday this old truck will be yours, Teddy Bear. But I know I'll never get to ride an 18-wheeler again. But this old base will let me keep in touch with my trucker friends. Well, Teddy Bear's gonna back on out now and leave you alone, 'cause it's time for Mama to come home. But you give me a shout when you're passing through, and I'll be glad to talk to you." Well, I came back and said, "Before you go to 1010, what's your home 20, little CB friend?" Well, he gave me his address, and I didn't once hesitate, 'cause this hot load of freight is just gonna have to wait. And I turned that truck around on a dime and headed straight for Jackson Street 229. Well, as I rounded the corner, I got a heck of a shock. 18-wheelers were lined up for 3 blocks. Well, I guess every trucker for miles around had caught Teddy Bear's call, and that little crippled boy was having a ball. For as fast as one driver could carry him in, another one would carry him out to his truck and take him off again. Well, you better believe I took my turn at riding Teddy Bear, and then I carried him back in and put him down in his chair. And buddy, if I never live to see happiness again, I want you to know I saw it that day in the face of that little man. We took up a collection for him before his mama got home, and each driver said goodbye, and then they were all gone. He shook my hand with a mile-long grin and said, "So long, trucker, I'll catch you again." Well, I hit that interstate with tears in my eyes, and I turned on the radio and got another surprise. "Breaker 19," came a voice on the air, "just one word of thanks from Mama Teddy Bear. We wish each and every one a special prayer for you, 'cause you just made my little boy's dream come true. I'll sign off now before I start to cry, and may God ride with you. 10-4 and goodbye."